What's going on, you guys? Welcome back to the channel, and today we're going to be reacting to Every Time You Leave by I Prevail. This is from the new album Trauma. This is the first song that I'm going to be reacting to from this album, except from the singles that came out, Breaking Down and Bow Down, and I think there might have, yeah, Paranoid. Besides for those three songs, this is the first one that I'm reacting to since the entire album came out, and I'm hyped for this. I've been hyped for it. I haven't been able to react to them because it was the weekend and I was away, so I am ready for this, and I'm going to be reacting to this full album, so if you're ready for that, please hit that subscribe button. We put just past 1,000 subscribers. I'm hyped for that. I'm going to have to eat mayonnaise at some point this week, so or next week, whenever I can get hands on mayonnaise. There's no mayonnaise today. I was planning on doing it, but there is none. So, yeah, this is what we're going to be doing today, and I'm hyped for it, and let's go. I love the other singles, by the way. I loved how they kind of mix Trap with it. Before it starts, it kind of reminds me of Bring Me the Horizon's new album, except way heavier, and better. Delaney Jane, is that somebody featuring? Okay, so it sounds like it's gonna be more of a laid-back song, more emotionally driven. Woo! Oh, I love the melodic sounds. And the reverb on the voice kind of reminds me of Mice of Men. The drums with the ambient vocals. Okay, so this must be Delaney Jane. She has a really nice voice. The guitar, it's kind of picking up. Duet chorus, maybe. Yeah, very smooth transition from verse to chorus there. That was really smooth. Alright, so what I'm getting from this song kind of might be, it kind of reminds me of a lot of those songs like Muse, Something Human, a bunch of other songs that are like that. What I'm interpreting from the lyrics here in the song is maybe it's from the perspective of either the person who wrote the song's loved one, wife, or whoever it is. Maybe from their perspective when they leave on tour and they have to leave and they're not there. That might be what it is. And the other one that I think it could be is just a relationship. The person keeps leaving, or basically just about a person leaving and how hard that is. And that's a pretty common thing for bands to do, because a lot of times they're on tour and they have to leave loved ones for a few months or however long it is. And I love songs like that because they kind of show you the other side of being in a band and doing big tours and stuff like that. They're kind of opening up to the fans and everybody basically about how that feels and how hard it can actually be. And I love that. I love the sound of this. Very melodic. Love the reverb on the voice. Again, it reminds me of older of Mice and Men. The vocalist has always reminded me of him a little bit. So we're gonna keep going. That is the wrong button. What the fuck is that? All right. This is more of just like a plain, not plain, but normal rock song, or I guess you could say metalcore. Not any trap or anything mixed in with it. Like, this could be released in 2010 and it would fit right into the metal genres at that time. Woo! I love female vocals in metalcore, post-metalcore, whatever you want to call it. They just work so well together. Especially both. Like that. That was really good. Or like chorus. Have a choir in there. I like that. Got the drums. Ooh, did you hear that drum? Oh, okay, it kind of goes into acoustic. Alright, still felt pretty modern. Had some of that modern feel in it, but also kept that older style, kind of that older style of metalcore, post-metalcore, like a sadder, slower version. Yeah, I think you know what I'm talking about. But overall, very good track. Actually, really like that track. Adding this whole album to my playlist, but I have to wait to listen to it until I react to all the songs, which sucks. But I loved this. I have never heard of Delling Jane, but I loved her voice in this. I don't know if she's a solo artist. I'm assuming she is. I don't know if she is on any other songs on this album. But I really like this song. It's the second song on the album, I'm pretty sure. I just went off the playlist in the I Prevail, on the I Prevail YouTube channel. Sometimes they're in order, sometimes they're not. So hopefully it's in order. I'll actually check on Spotify, see if it's in order. I haven't seen the track list or anything yet. So yeah, I actually love that track. It kind of surprised me that it was more of a laid back and slower song that they would put second. But I guess that does make sense. They'd want to start off the album with Bow Down really heavy, and then they'll go into maybe like a second, more of a lower, sadder, slower song to make it, to show everybody that this album is not just all heavy or not just all sad. It kind of just shows off both sides of the album at the same time, right next to each other. And I like that. They're doing a good job with this album so far. I'm gonna have to recheck out Afterlife and Lifelines, I believe, were their first two albums. I think it's Afterlife. I don't remember. It's been a long time since I've listened to those. I remember Lifelines a little bit, but I remember liking them, but I don't remember the actual songs themselves, except for Blank Space. So I'm excited to check those out, and excited to check the rest of this album out. I'm sorry I'm a little bit tired right now, so I'm a little bit slow and probably stuttering a little bit, but I'll be better, alright? I just had to react to this one now because I've been very busy. So, thank you guys so much for watching. If you did enjoy this, please like, subscribe, comment, follow us on Twitter. Link is down in the description. We just hit 1,000 subscribers. I cannot wait to eat that mayonnaise. Anyway. Oh. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. And as always, peace. Baby, just help calm me down. 'Cause I'm on the edge of a cliff now. Swimming near the verge of a something to pray to. You will see me in the night sky. Feel my presence in the cold wind. And I swear that I will wrap you in the day. Don't worry, my love will not disintegrate. You see me as dead, but it's dreaming. Asleep in my bed, so stay alive.